change of plans. I'm just gonna take a trek down this way.
Good morning, internet. It is 8:20 in the morning and welcome back to the channel. Now, as you can see, I have a new plate and I attached it now straight on this one with 3 bolts. The plate actually arrived earlier than they said, so that was a really pleasant surprise, to be honest. So I immediately put it on and now I'm ready to go. I had a pretty cool time here in Vietma. In the weekend it was the annual International Folklore Festival. So I had a look, how was that? So here is some footage from that day. So it turns out that today is the International Day of the Folklore. Never knew. And this is how they celebrate that in Vietma. El bailarín. So in the program I saw that there's a singing and dancing and all sorts of activities.
Buenas.
So I'm really enjoying all the local dances. A lot of it, I think, is Argentinian style. But for example, the group with the girls with the hats, they're a Bolivian group. And I've been told that it's a Bolivian community that lives here. So they didn't come especially all the way from Bolivia to dance here. But it is a Bolivian folklore. It's a bit difficult for me to really figure out what is from where. They do announce it, but I don't understand everything they say. But yeah, it's really cool and it's starting to get quite busy as well.
Buenas tardes a todos.
Oh, next act.
Vayan acercando.
¿Dónde estará el corazón? El que conoce si es cierto.
Chacarera de una.
How cool is that? That last song, that wasn't an act, all those people dancing, it was just free dancing. And it's just, I don't know, it's just really amazing to see that everybody knows these local dances. I'm gonna head back. I really enjoyed this. It was amazing to see, and now I actually feel kind of lucky that I lost my number plate, because if I wouldn't have lost my number plate, I wouldn't have been here today. I would have already left Vietma. So this actually was an opportunity to see this local dance and yeah, just spend an afternoon with some local people. It was really, really nice. They say every time a door closes, another one opens, and that is so true. But now I am ready to go again. I'm really excited. I'll show you on the map where I'm gonna go today. So I am now here in Vietma in Argentina, and this circle is from that day ride that I did to see the parrots and the parakeets and the sea lions. And today I'm gonna ride here to Puerto Madryn. In the beginning I will take the Ruta 3, but then somewhere here I can also ride here along the coast again on some small road. So I'm gonna see if I can do that and then ride small road all the way down to Puerto Madryn. In total it's gonna be about, what was it now? 400... I already forgot, 400 kilometers or something? 460? I don't know, but it's gonna be a full day. Oh yeah, I also had an oil change done on Dunno while I was here, so that was pretty good timing. Of course, the first service she already had when I was still in the Netherlands, because the first service is already after 600 kilometers. That's a really quick one. And now I'm just back to like the normal service intervals.
Thank you.
just covered about 200 kilometers in absolute flat terrain. And finally I see some mountains over there, which actually comes as a surprise because I thought the entire way would be flat. So I'm a little over halfway now. I think it's about 200 kilometers to go. It's actually quite a long day today. This morning I felt, how long was it? 380, 400, but it's 480 kilometers today, so it's quite a long day. But I'm more than halfway, and my plan was originally to take a left turn in about 2 kilometers from here, then ride to the coast and take a dirt track around there for fun. But now that I saw these mountains, well, you can't see it now, but those small mountains, and I saw a dirt track going that direction. So I thought, change of plans, I'm just gonna take a track down this way, see if I can get a little bit closer, see if I ride around there a little bit and then take a small break. Because, well, it's past lunchtime and I don't want to waste a lot of time looking for food. So now I have some snacks with me, so I'm just gonna eat those and then continue my way. So let's go. Look at them. Awesome. Don't eat me. Yeah, this is the spot. I'm gonna eat something and maybe fly the drone a little bit. That'd be cool. Nice place, huh? Really cool. But I think the funny thing is that if you would see something like this in the middle of the Alps or something, okay, you won't, but theoretically you wouldn't be really impressed. But it's just after riding 200 kilometers in just absolute flat terrain, when I see this I get just all super excited. I think it's really beautiful here. I'm enjoying the ride. My lunch is going to be an orange, some muesli bars, and this is some dried fruit and nuts. Right, let's continue to Puerto Madryn. In Puerto Madryn. Made it. That was a really stunning view coming from over that hill and then seeing the whole city. Pretty cool. Casino.
That is disgusting. Hostel. All right, I'm going to stay here. They have a nice garden, so I'm gonna park the Knoll inside. This way, I think. Yes.
So I'm staying in a pretty cool place. This is my room. I have my own front door. And this is the room. And then I have a key to a bathroom, which is just around the corner. So, very nice. I just really look forward to actually the next ride already, because the reason why I came here to Puerto Madryn is that there's a peninsula very close by, which is called Isla Valdez, I believe. And from there you can see a lot of wildlife, so I'm really looking forward to it, or at least I hope I'm gonna spot some wildlife. So in the next ride I'm gonna ride a circle around the peninsula and then come back here again. So that was it for today. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up and subscribe down below, and then I'll see you in the next video.